I want you guys to sit up straight. Close your eyes. Hands across the chest, please. Close your eyes. I want you to take a deep breath through your nose. Just through your nose. Time to relax. Time to meditate. Time to focus on your blessings and not your burdens. Anything that's bothering you, been pulling you down, bothering your mind, any type of burden, barrier, groominess, I want you to throw it away right now, discard it. Anything that's any type of struggle, strain, or stress that's been plaguing you, I want you to just right now get rid of it. Trial, tribulation, or trouble, just throw it away. Won't you just focus on how good it is to see another day that was promised to you. A day that you had no control over, but you were blessed to see. Won't you give me 7 deep breaths through your nose. 7 deep breaths through your nose. Anything that's ungodly, unhealthy, or unholy, I want you to just dismiss those thoughts. I want you to focus on things that are godly, that are healthy, and that are holy. This is your time to just meditate and just relax. Give me 7 more deep breaths, please, through your nose. Listen to the music. This is your moment to just maximize. Just focus on you. So many times we do for others, we just don't take time out. Breathe. Keep your eyes closed, please. We don't take time out to even breathe. We just constantly helping out others. Many times we find time to help out our own selves. But this is your moment. Relax. Okay, you can open your eyes now. Let's start marching in the chair. Just marching in the chair. Okay, pump those arms. Pump those arms. Pump those knees. Bring those knees up high. I'm really looking for making sure you're coordinated. Right? Focus on opposites. When you bring your, when you pump your right arm, bring it to the left knee. When you pump the left arm, bring it to the right knee.
Well,
that's better, that's better, that's better. You're getting there. We teach them, isn't that? We teach them. We teach them. Keep going. Seven. Keep going. Concentrate on. There you go. Opposite. When you pump, when you bring it right, bring it to the left. Direction pump right now. Now bring it to the left. Bring it to the left knee.
Left knee right off. Oh.
There it is. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Go bring it up high.
Good.
Right arm.
Left knee.
Left arm, right knee. Okay. Yeah, there you go.
Okay.
Yeah. So think about it. When you're running, that's what you do. You know? Okay. You do whatever you want. You're not running like this.
No.
I hope not.
I get the new word.
Yeah, not bad.
Be running too fast.
Come on. Hey, look faster. Bring it up. Keep going. Knees up high. Arms up high. So, Mr. Lena.
Hello.
I'm moving gears, man. I want y'all to come back a little bit. Come back a little bit. There you go. Get everybody in the family. There you go.
Yeah, I gotta get in. So I'm gonna get myself.
Again, this morning, so we're talking about love. Okay, let's reach. 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 Reach as high as you can. Bring your knees up high. Come on. Reach. 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 There you go. Reach. Reach. Come on, Sam. Come on. Reach. Come on.
Out, back, in, down. Come on, baby. Out, back, in, down. Out, back, in, down.
Keep your back straight.
In, down. Out, back, and down. Out, back, in, down. Out, back, in, down. Out, back, in, down. Out, back. Keep moving. Out, back, in, down. Out, back, in, down. Back, in, down. Out, back, in, down.
Okay, switch legs now. Switch legs. Go back and forth. Right leg, left leg. Now just doing one leg. Go both legs. Both legs.
Work.
Air.
Thank you.
All right, while you marching, you marching.
Go up, come on. Here, you marching. Here, down. Up, down. Up, down. Keep moving. Up, down. Come on. Up, down. Keep moving. Up, down. Down.
Up, down. 2 minutes this time.
Up, come on.
Down, come on.
Up, down,
come on.
Up, down.
Come on. Let's move. Got a minute to go. Keep going. Do what you can. If you're feeling light here, I want you to sit in the chair, please.
Would that happen?
No, if you're feeling light here, I want you to sit in the chair.
Well, I'm gonna sit in the chair.
Okay, well, yeah, that's fine. You think about it. You're going at your own pace.
That's what I'm saying.
You're not competing with anybody.
Right,
but
I
still want you to do it.
Yeah. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna go out and get a surprise.
No, right now.
Oh!
Yeah, no, stop. You gotta sit down. This gotta sit down when you exempt. Keep going. Oh. 30 more seconds. Let's go. Keep on those legs, Mr. Robert. We're gonna need them.
Shoulders in your now, isn't it?
Yeah. I heard it all before.
This ain't hurt.
March. Hands across the chest. Keep marching. Move them down a little bit. Hands across the chest. Keep marching.
Okay, right.
What's up, Mr. Dean?
Good morning, Evan.
What's going on, brother?
How's everybody?
Last week we had a discussion about what's best. Read mouth, but I wouldn't. He wasn't sure.
No, that's right, that's right. Yeah. I wasn't totally sure.
Right. But you were told.
What I was going on was what I have observed.
Okay, go ahead.
This is what I said. People that run track, do the cross-country run, when they stop, yeah, I'll tell you if I'm wrong or not. Don't they stop, start beating their mouth like, am I right? That's what I thought.
Okay, but I'm saying.
But I'm saying, this is what the papers say, but I'm saying, nah.
Right, okay, what you've observed. But we're right here, I want to deal with some facts right now. And he's going to explain the facts of what's the best, how best to breathe. Go ahead.
Okay, he said I am. That's fine. I'm going to try it. I'm going to try it. I'm a run thing, you know what I'm talking about. Really, really big mouth, many niggas. These are some of the researchers who believe that mouth breathing is associated with hyperventilation, causes accelerated asthma, is it asthma? Asthma, and high blood pressure, heart disease, and many other medical problems.
That's mouth breathing. It's about mouth breathing.
Yeah,
okay.
Mouth breathing. Okay.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay, always better whenever possible to be deviated, septum and small nostrils may make it impractical, but still, nose breathing 24 hours a day is extremely important for those who desire the longest and most healthy life. Okay.
You don't have to read all of it, but I'm just saying.
Okay, let's just say number one. Yeah. Take number one.
Yeah, that's cool.
That's cool. Lungs are primarily the source of energy level. The exact oxygen from the air we breathe primarily on the exhale because the nostrils are smaller than the mouth. Air exhale through the nose creates back pressure, and when it exhales, it slows the air escape so the lungs may have more time to extract oxygen from them. When there is a proper oxygen carbon dioxide exchange, the blood will maintain a balanced pH. If carbon dioxide is lost too quickly, as the mouth breathing, oxygen absorption is decreased.
So, bottom line is what?
Nose breathing is better. I understand it, but that's what they say. Is it true? Is it true? But it's not what happens when you breathe.
I understand it, but they're saying, I mean, the article is saying, I mean, not saying, but the article explained, rather, I guess.
Such mouth breathing also accelerates water loss and increasing possible dehydration. Okay. I didn't know that.
Well, that paper's for you. Mm-hmm. That paper's for you. And if you want to make copies for anybody, have Miss Alina make copies for anybody.
Don't you forget anything? Everything.
What? Oh, are you talking about bringing that out?
Make sure you brought this.
I told you I was going to do it.
You told me you did. It's your fault. You had something to do with this too.
I didn't. It's not that I remember everything, but I, right after we talked, I distinctly, remember
you
that.
You got right on this, I see.
Yeah. So.
It says nose breathing has many benefits over mouth. It's respiration.
Okay.
That is good. Did everybody get one in?
Just you.
You need it. Until we
well,
just
bottom win. Line is, Miss Lena, Miss Lena can make some comments for you guys.
That's for you.
Yeah, but it's for you.
Oh, you got some comments.
Yeah.
And, well, I should thank you, man. I'm glad you really thought of me. You were an example out of me in class.
No, I'm just saying.
Just for you. Okay.
Not supposed to make an example, but just I want to follow up on what we're talking about.
Yeah, because the reason I say it is because everybody will agree that not that it's good for you, but everybody does.
Yeah.
That's what I would say, But I don't know which is best.
No, I'm not saying.
Well, I was going to say that I think that the example that you brought up about like a marathon runner at the very end, they are exhausted, so it's like whatever way they can get some air in, they'll do it.
That's right.
But when you are just basically meditating or just normal, then it's you usually.
Well, I would tend to agree. Yeah, but we're talking about overall whether it's best and what people do, or it's good or bad. I think it's not good, but I know everybody does. Anytime you run, you're going to stop breathing. You've been in the military. hill, up a mountain, it breathes you up. You try to get as much oxygen as you can as quick as possible. You know?
Yeah.
But not,
I'm just saying overall, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, because the article, you know, brings out about when you breathe your mouth, you do lose, you become dehydrated. And so overall, no breathing is best. Yeah. That's my point. That's the point I was bringing on. And I want to bring it, share with flies, but mainly you want to fly, you want to know, so that's where you.
Yeah, well,
that's all, no, it's all good though. No, I want to bring you on the spot.
I just really appreciate you and all of you.
The topic, let's go ahead and talk about what we're going to talk about. I'm about to share. We're talking about love.
Love.
It's all good.
And you can get out of my seat, so.
No, no, no.
I had my coffee with you. Okay. I have one of these.
Yeah, you do. You do.
Okay.
Yeah, you do. And we're going to go with that fifth question.
Fifth question?
Yeah, where does love. Where does love begin?
At home.
Where does love begin? Anybody?
Yeah, like charity begin at home.
Hmm?
That's right.
Where does love begin? Anybody?
Home.
Home? Like, why do you say home?
Because it's where charity begins. Right? According to the Bible.
I'm just trying to say,
I know, I'll give you an answer, but is it right or wrong? You want to get some feedback? Girl, these other people can say what they want. I'm just saying what I
want. There's no right or wrong answer. It's just a question. It's right.
That's
what
I'm
saying. Is that what you're going
to say? I know. I wanted to hear what you had to say, but I'm going
to talk. No, I'm just opening up to everybody right now.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
so like, but love is very important, you know.
But where does it begin?
It begins with you. You love yourself.
Okay.
And then if you love yourself, then you can love others.
Okay.
But I was saying, when you know what love is, you had to be taught. So parents had to teach you what love is.
Okay.
When you were little.
So it's something that's learned.
It's something.
Love is learned.
Yeah, you get that affection when you're small, so you know what love is.
Okay. There's no right or wrong answer. That's the thing.
I'm just saying, that's where
right.
That's where I got it.
Right. Okay. Look, I know you high enough. You can work it out.
I'm talking like this. Oh, I'm trying to stop.
I know you still hyped up from your two workouts this morning, so.
Thank you.
But let me ask you this, then what she's saying is love is a learned behavior, right?
Right. Just like hate is.
Just like hate?
Hate.
Hey, you yeah. Or dislike, strong dislike.
Right. Okay.
Yeah, you learn, those are behaviors that you learn.
Right, that's good. Okay.
Yeah.
That's good.
You learn. You learn to learn. You know, and anybody else? Ms. Rob?
No.
Ms. Hayden?
No.
Where's love again?
It begins stemming from the heart and within you. Within you.
So, we talked about it learned. How hard is it to love?
Very hard.
No, it's not. It's easy. I think it depends on the situation. In some situations, you can love very easily, and then in adverse conditions, you have to work at it.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Have patience.
Mm-hmm.
You have to be a good liar, too.
You're a liar?
Yeah, because I'm just seeing how. I used to lie to girls and tell them I love them. That was a lie. You know, it was a lie. But it might be two different kinds of love we're talking about, but I'm talking about love.
Yeah.
Do you love me? See, you know I love you.
Well, I understand that one too.
Yeah, I learned to lie like that. And walking the truth teacher, you look at you fall in love, look at the hell, look at the hell, look at him. It's tough. You know what I'm talking about, don't you?
No.
Yes, you do.
Love yourself if you're lying to somebody.
Well, you're lying to yourself because you're lying for a purpose, you know, you're trying get old. I mean, that just, when growing up, that's what I would do. I want to be a kid, I want to be a winner, you know.
But it's still your thing.
But that's not love. That's not love.
No,
so it's a distinction between love and lying, you know.
Okay, here's what I think. When you say I love you, does that mean you're lying and telling the truth? See, just to say the words I love you means a lot to some people. They say, I want to hear how you feel. You say you love me, okay, that's good enough to kill me. If you don't love yourself, you don't love anybody else. that is God too.
That's true.
Now, I'm joking around and play around a little bit, but I think she gave the best answer overall, because from there it stems out, I think. You know, if you love yourself, you start loving your job, you love what you do, people, you love your interaction with people.
But that's as you get older.
No, not when you know. This is when you're
when
more
you're
mature.
Young.
But when you're more mature, is what you're not.
I understand that, but I'm talking about when you're like, I would say 2, 3,
oh,
whatever, like that.
Know.
You get that.
You don't even know who you are.
That's what I'm saying. That's when you learn this love from other people that's showing you affection.
No,
and you just,
I think that's when you begin to feel things, but you don't know who you are.
That's what I'm saying.
You
can't say that.
You don't know anything when you're 3. You know, you're not. You're
right.
I remember when I was 2. How about that?
I remember stuff when I was 2, too. And there's a difference between the
and that's why I tell you, that's why I got this being loved from my parents.
When you were 2 years old?
Yes. I think I had the best parents in the world.
Oh, no.
But I mean, I'm just saying, I think I had the best parents in the world.
That's beautiful said. A lot of people.
That's what I know this.
If you feel that way,
yes.
Express it. And that's one of the things I say, are you blessed to be how your parents?
No, they're both
just. Okay. Because I was about to say, one thing I expressed here is that it's important to express I love you more often. You know,
yeah.
Anytime you wait till
I know.
No, I'm just saying. I'm saying that. Express the words, not only in word, but in action.
You're right.
And
that's
how
some
of
the action and words.
Right.
That's
right.
What
I'm
saying.
Like I said, not only in word, but in action.
That's what the sixth, well, I have 5 other siblings, and we are close.
Right.
And we have our get together, just the 6 of us every year.
Right.
And
let me tell you something that has occurred to me over the last couple of years. I guess it's really come to turn. You know, people are more apt to say brother and sister when I say, oh, when you finish the conversation, I love you. I love you too.
Mm-hmm.
I remember one time I thought it was kind of bumpish, you know.
Yeah.
I thought. But in talking to my son, my wife, now he's a big boy.
Right.
He's about 6'2", weighs about 285, 290, you know, big, fat, not fat, big boy, like the boy got that. Anyway. And when we finished talking, I said, well, hey, man, I'll talk to you, man, you got your son, you know, today. Hey, son, I go, hey, man. I said, I'll talk to you later. He's okay, Bobby. I love you. I said, I love you, too. And he said, hey, I meant that.
I'm trying.
And then my sisters, I can't stand one of them. I really can't stand my baby sister.
Right.
Because she don't know more than I do. She a baby sister now. But, boy, oh, excuse me, you know. But I'm still be talking, get to talking and saying, hey kid, I'm talking to this, okay, or my niece, you know, I love you, Uncle. I said, I love you too. I said, so, how is where you love is coming easy now. It's going to be hard.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to tell y'all anything more.
That's right. I believe it.
Now, with my father,
yeah.
It's hard, for him it's hard, to me, my position is, it's hard for him to say. My mama, it just comes out like that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I mean, as soon as I get off the phone, we both
say
I love you.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
I mean, both. My dad, when I tell him that I love him, I mean, I'll tell him every now and then that I love him, but most of the time I'll just say, love you both. Because with dad, it's been different. I just have a different relationship with my mom. I love him.
You know.
But my mother, I'm humble. I just tell my mom I love her. No problem. But go ahead.
Before my dad died, I guess y'all said, this nigga can talk. Issues of
yeah.
I go, you know, anyway.
We talked about that word a couple of weeks ago. We talked about that word. The N word. But go ahead.
Okay. My dad, before he died, I used to cut hair, you know.
Yeah.
And he talked to us how to cut hair.
Right.
But he had a stroke. And these are things that you start remembering by reflecting back. At least I should have done this, I should have done this. My dad had one time, I met this girl. And I had a new Thunderbird, black Thunderbird. I thought I was all that, bad at chips, you know what I mean?
Right.
So I had a date with her that night.
Did you tell him you loved him?
Ooh, I did.
Go ahead, go ahead. Go ahead. Did you lie to her too? Go ahead.
Wait a minute. So what happened is, I was getting ready to go out and meet my dad. He had stroke on the left side. Your left side, your left hand. So he couldn't.
Appreciate it.
And you?
So your father had a stroke on the left side?
Sit down, let me finish.
I'm not talking to you!
Anyway, so when he was in the bathroom and put some shaving cream on his face.
Your father?
Yeah, standing in the mirror. And I was wondering, Dad, come on out of there. I gotta come. I need to look in the mirror, get myself together. You know, I'm ready to go. And he said, son, he said, we got time, man. He said, I kept trying to shave his right hand. He couldn't, his left hand. And he kept falling, raised his arm. He said, Daddy, you're in the way. Come on out of the mirror. We get in the mirror so I can get cuted up. I gotta go. So he said, son, you got time to give your dad a shave. I said, oh, Daddy, I got to date with this girl. You know, and I'm already late. This is what I thought about in retrospect. And I said, man, after he died, I said, I didn't have time to shave my dad. And I felt horrible about that. Yeah, because he taught me how to cut hair and shave. And all of us boys, and I was the only one home.
So that was the last time you...
Wow. That was the last time I remember I could have done something for him. Right. And I did.
He did.
And we took him to the hospital, and the doctor had said, Mr. Nixon, do you remember what, do you know who the brother was? He said, Roosevelt, I think. I said, oh man, my dead mind is going too, you know. At all times, I was sleeping on my head, had the stroke. And I thought, I said, hey, at first I felt like I'm living, because you always think your dad's strong, he'll be here for now. Right. When the mountains fall dead from you. But I saw my dad crumbling, you know. And that's when I wanted to tighten up, but it was too late, he was dying, you know.
Yeah. Yeah.
Anyway, that's what I thought about. Huh.
So you sort of regret?
Sure, I regret it a million times. Anything you could have done for your people, you're gonna pay for that. You're gonna give account for that, huh?
God forgive me for you.
God forgive me for yourself. Thank you for asking. Because I can think back, man, that's anytime I could have came to my mom told me one time, I told her about dance floor. You know how they say it's like dance floor to disco. And I said, Mom, she said, gosh, ain't never something like that in my life. She said, how you feel about that? And this restaurant down Reunion Tower, you see Bob run.
Yeah.
I told Mom about that one time. I said, you mean you be way up in there and you can go around? Ooh, I'd love to see that. I never thought, I could have took my mama there. I had the money. I didn't have the time.
No, you had the time.
Yeah.
No, I would take the time.
Right. You had the time.
Yeah.
We had time to do whatever we wanted to do.
Yeah, I regretted it a million days. And I don't want to do it now. I don't want to fail my son. It's the first thing I'm working on now.
Right.
I said, first of all, I can't give everything. And he don't ask me anything. But I want to be there for him. He tell me if you need anything, call me. Like I can give it to him. I ain't got no money or nothing, you know.
You know,
he's so independent. He won't call me. He won't say, I'm okay, Bob. I'm okay, Bob. He's saying, God, he was 30-something years old. And I can't think of a whole lot I've done for him in life other than, you know, being dead.
Right. Well, I mean, you know,
I love it.
One of my professors once told me, learning is lifelong. And so, not so much from the academic, but just socially. I mean, you know, you learn from your experience with your parents.
Yeah.
Now, what you can do with your son, you know, that's what I always talk about, maximizing your moments.
Yeah.
You know, and whatever moment you have with your loved one, maximize. Love that person during that moment to the maximum. That's what I'm
saying. One other question, I'm sure, though. I'm going to say this. Do you all have trouble with your family, with visiting family, coming together? We don't have trouble. My family's pretty close, but I think it's important that you see your family. Once a week, if you can, or every 2 weeks, get together some kind of way.
Right.
Because you don't know when something's going to come up and they ain't going to be there. They meet and you say, I should have got with them. I didn't mean to call them. The reason I said I got my last living auntie, my sister, the little one that I don't like, but I love her.
Your baby sister?
Yeah. She took my auntie out, my mother's brother's wife.
You talking about?
And she took her out to eat the other day. And I said, why didn't you call somebody? Well, this is what I already said. Y'all not calling after. Why I got to be on the call? I said, no, I just want to say, why didn't you call her? I know you're going to take her out. We all went together, so. Well, I'm not going to report to you and nobody else, but I already told you. I want to say, I can kill her. I can take her papa here.
Don't say that. Because you're, yeah, I know you're worried about it.
Ain't
but you got understand her giver.
Okay, but my thing is this here. This is our dad living out here. And my sister, who does this, she's like that. She wants everybody to look at her like she's the one that's really getting things together.
But
she's
do they?
No, she has a lot of animosity with everybody because of her attitude, you know. It's not just you in the world. There's something she has. But I did my part. Y'all didn't do y'all part.
See, everybody don't know how to love. They don't know how to express themselves.
Right.
You know, sometimes they have attitude like that toward the family, but maybe deep down inside she really loves the family.
Well, I think she's,
you know what I'm saying?
She's hurting me.
Yeah, it's hurting. Some people is hurting these people, hurt other people.
And actually, our next subject, starting next week, we're going to deal with forgiveness. You know?
Okay.
And, you know, and the important, like I said, forgiving is not, it's not about that person. It's for you. You know, it's to relieve and free yourself. And because when you don't forgive, you let that baby bottle up. It's just like a cancer many times. You know, cancer metastasizes.
And
just spreads throughout the body. And just like forgiveness. You get to the point where it continue to grow and you blow up and you end up regretting something or regretting saying something that you cannot take back. And so that's what we'll be dealing with next week, forgiveness. But is that you about to say something else?
Yeah, I was about to say, like, for love.
Right.
Love is, you know, like your children are coming up.
Right.
Love is that I'm confused with love with discipline. Because if you love your children, you're going to do what? Discipline them. And chastise them because you love them.
Right.
Now, they may grow up and take it another kind of way, you know?
Right.
But that's what I think.
Yeah.
I was going to say that. I don't know if you should see your family at least once a week. I always thought, and I know a friend of mine now who, you remember the soul food story where they would get together every Sunday, all the family members?
Yeah.
You like your movie too?
Yeah. And then I have a friend that does that now. I mean, it's just her immediate kids and husband and grandkids. Every week she cooks and everything and they come over. I think that is so
cool. Oh, yeah. Because otherwise, in that casket,
they can't hear you.
something else, learned behavior coming from family interaction too.
Yeah.
In our family, we don't have any drinking or cursing or hell raising, you know. Nobody's drunk when you're in the family, you just get together. It's just giving, hey, let's have it down here. Everybody brings something, you know, you bring some Bible, you bring a gift, you bring this, you kick it. And then we're gonna go, we're gonna meet over source of the house, go over there, we'll be laughing, talk, watch the games, or down together, or play dominoes, end of it. Either go home.
Yeah.
You know, you ain't gotta do no long outstanding thing. But it's just getting together, so you get familiar with it. I wanna see my cousin.
Right.
And I know some little kids, they'll hug each other, whatever, they take dolls, and little girls, you know. Little boys wanna go outside and play basketball, and
right.
Throw
some but they just having fun. Having fun, they love
each other. Yeah, yeah. That's you, all you begin to love your family. Right. I love my cousins.
Right. Right.
Like my grandkids, they're out of town. I only have 2 here, but I consider that grandma day. That means we'll go to a movie and go eat pizza. Let me just enjoy that day together.
Right.
That's how I do. Mm-hmm. And I call the other ones. They're out of town.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. We're learning a few things. There's a lot of things we haven't done before.
Well, you don't have to tell them. We have to work in different things.
Yeah, but you take that time sometimes, yeah.
Come on, Ms. Dean. Okay, we talked about love enough. Ms. Dean, I love you. Just get on the phone. Facing me.
Okay, what are we gonna do?
Bring your knees to your chest right now.
What?
Knees hold on. To knees chest. To your chest. Let me adjust my camera. Bring your knees to your chest.
Are you comfortable? How you get out of here?
Okay, now knees to your chest.
Okay.
Hands behind your head.
Behind your head.
Uh-huh. Okay, take your legs straight out. No, out.
Out.
Out. Just out. Just like that. Yeah, just out. Out. Take him out. Out. No, I didn't say open. Out. Now open.
All right, you're gonna hear it, but you know.
Close. Back to your chest.
Okay. Open.
Do it again.
Back to your chest.
Keep going.
Open. Close. Back to your chest.
There you go. Out. Open. Close. That's 4. Come on. Out. Open. Close. Chest. Out. Open. Close. Chest. That's 6. Out. Open. Close. Chest. 7. Out. Open. Close. Chest. That's 7. Out. Open. Close. Chest. That's 8. Out. Open. Close. Chest. That's 9. Out. Open. Close. And 10. Good job. Good job. Relax.
Good.
Hey, don't hold your breath. Keep breathing. Be your nose, okay? Matter of fact, I want you to count with me. That way you automatically breathe, all right? Okay. Now, legs straight out. Okay? Now, give me 30 degrees. Bring them up 30 degrees. 30. Just 30. Just 30. 30. Now 45. Bring my 45. Now 60. Now 90. Down back to 30. 45. 60. 90. Back to 30. 45. 60. 90. That's 4. Back to 30. 45. 60. 90. Come on. 30, 45, 60, 90, back to 30. Come on. Give me five more. 30, 45, 60, and 90. Come on. 30, 45, 60, 90. Come on. 30, 45, 60, 90. 2 more. Back to 30, 45, 60, 90. One more, baby. One more. 30, 45, 60, and 90. Good job. Good job.
Wonderful.
Good job. Okay. Hands across chest. my chest, everybody.
Wait, who coming down there?
We done already been.
You ain't been on this.
Oh yeah. First set. Yeah. Y'all come on up. Everybody hands cross chest. Eyes closed. Deep breath in your nose. Time to get this final meditation. Final meditation. Final meditation. Time to relax your mind. Focus on your blessings, not your burdens. Thank you again for being a part of the Gerocise remark, emotional empowerment. Like I said, guys, what next week we'll be discussing forgiveness. Deep breath, you know.